This is completely surprising, but Derek Fisher and I have the exact same athletic philosophy. The
really?
Bodies are great. Why wreck it now? The five-time NBA champion turned coach turned sports analyst is here to talk about the hottest weekend of the year taking place for NBA fans in L.A. Nice to see you. But
thank
what
you.
We both agree is, you know what? You don't want to go out in the court and play basketball, you know, informally.
No, no. My body feels great.
Right.
The first step in the morning is comfortable now.
Right,
yeah.
Right.
Compared to what it used to feel
sure,
like.
Sure, of course.
So I'm keeping it safe. More on the grass with the golf swing
okay.
than on the hardwood with the basketball.
But D-Fish, do you miss that camaraderie of being on the team and being out there?
For sure.
Yeah.
I mean, I think as an athlete, even before being a pro, you know, from the time I was 6 years old and first started playing organized sports.
Yeah.
Being a part of a team, part of a group, you know, helping other people accomplish great things, not just yourself.
Yeah.
You know, that's what being a part of a team is all about. So I definitely miss those things. But, you know, my kids and my loved ones are my team now.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So spending more time with them.
Well, you know, it's so funny because Gary Payton was here, as you'll recall, just a couple weeks ago, and he's quite tall.
Yes.
And he says people are like, I could take you on. And you were suggesting because you're not – that you're the size of the rest of mere mortals that people
yes.
really think that they could.
Yeah, no, I see people all the time that,
right.
you know, one, they're surprised that I'm not 5 foot one instead of 6 foot one.
Right.
And then the second thing is, yeah, I could probably take you.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I'm not Kobe size, I'm not Shaq size. But, you know, a lot of guys thought that over the years.
Yeah, and then they embarrassed
you have been very effective as a coach. Would that appeal to you again?
For sure. You know, I'm sure some people in New York would disagree that I was effective, but no, I learned a lot. I enjoyed the process. I'm thankful for the opportunity. Not very many people can say they've been a head coach in the NBA.
Mm.
It's only 30 of those jobs in the world.
Mm. Yeah.
And I had the opportunity to share it for a while. So I'm looking forward to the opportunity when it presents itself again. I'll be ready for it. If it doesn't, you know, there are a lot of colleges and universities out there as well.
Okay.
But I just love basketball, and I think sport is a way of just helping young people grow, and I love to be a part of it.
Gosh, I think you're so right about that. Now, the smart sport coat also leads people to know you've had a lot of TV work now, too.
Yes.
You're joking, because who picked out that jacket?
Not me.
Okay, exactly right.
The TV work, I have so much more respect for what goes on that people don't see.
Right. Yeah.
You know, I think you guys come on and you just make it look easy. All the right words come out, everything's in place, but it is not easy. There's a lot of work that goes into it. And doing that type of work has been fun because it's given me a different perspective about not just the game of basketball, but also appreciating how many other people play a role in making this sporting event come to life.
Mm.
The crew, the cameramen and women behind the scenes, the grips. Everybody plays a role in turning this basketball game into an event. So it's been cool to be a part of it.
Speaking of event, NBA All-Star Weekend. So what's happening in town this weekend?
Oh, so many things. Obviously, a lot of parties at nighttime, but that's not what NBA All-Star Weekend is about. It used to be known for just the game and the parties.
Mm-hmm.
Now, all throughout the day, tons of community activities, people giving back, doing great things in L.A. So the NBA has a day of service where all of the all-stars, rising stars, young people scattered all around L.A. doing great things in the community, touching people. The NBA now has a technology summit where they discuss how technology is going to impact sports and the game of basketball moving forward.
Wow. Okay. Now, see, that's really interesting to me because I would think compared to a lot of other sports, and we were talking about golf before, and, you know, the club gets better every year. I would think basketball wouldn't have any technological changes, really, to the actual game.
I don't think the game itself is changing, but the ability to track data, which all big companies are trying to do, that's where the game is really going to change. Tracking the data, the recovery time of the players, understanding more maybe when players are reaching that point where injury is going to be, you know, coming up soon.
Right.
So there are a lot of those aspects of the game where technology really helps. The analytics in terms of the numbers and tracking the opponent. So the Tech Summit is also a big part of it. But, you know, Saturday night has become such a big thing. It's not just the All-Star game Sunday, but the three-point contest, the dunk contest.
Yeah, right.
And then seeing the young All-Stars that aren't All-Stars yet, but those guys in their first and second year get a chance to see them on Friday night. So it's a fun weekend, and it's a family-friendly weekend. So hopefully everybody will get out and have some fun.
We'll tell people about it. The 2018 NBA All-Star Weekend is this weekend. Starts tomorrow, February 16th, 17th, and 18th. The whole thing at Staples Center. Ticket information, NBA.com/All-Star. Don't want to miss all the activities. What a play. You have to come and fill in for me one day.
Or any of us. You're too good, man. Maybe one of these guys behind the scenes.
Okay, fair enough.
Thanks, Derek. Good to see you.
Thank you.